Hey guys, welcome to my channel and thank you so much for stopping by. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to share with you how to achieve this beautiful, colorful, half cut crease eye look. And I have hooded eyes, so I'll be sharing with you so many tips and tricks. Today's video is actually a collaboration video with my YouTuber friend Shahela. She is a Bangladesh-based YouTuber and she has created this beautiful brown and gold half cut crease eye look, and we both have used our Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette to create our looks. I will mention her channel link in the description bar down below as well as on the pinned comment. So please do support her channel and please do subscribe to her channel as well. And yeah, without further ado, let's get started. So first I'm taking my Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer in the shade medium. I'm just cleaning up the borders of my brows so that my brows look well shaped and defined. I recently shared with you my updated eyebrow routine. I will have the video linked in the description bar down below, so please do check that out. I'm applying the same concealer on my eyelids to prime my eyelids for eyeshadow that is coming up next. And I like to use my concealer as my eyeshadow base. You can use any eyeshadow primer that you have in your collection. Now I'm just blending it out using a damp beauty sponge. This sponge is from Wet n Wild. Now I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder in the shade 15. And I'm just setting the concealer so that it does not crease. And I have taken a very little amount of the powder. And if you take a lot of powder, then it may become dry and crusty and your eyeshadows will not sit properly on top of it. I have taken two pieces of this sticky tape and applied it on the back of my hand to get rid of the excess glue. Now I'm just applying it right here on the outer part of my eyelid to have that nice sharp edge. And for my eyes, first I'm taking Cheap from my Jaclyn Hill palette, of course, and it's a beautiful dark brown shade. And with this pencil brush, I am applying it slightly above my crease. You can see my natural crease right across my eyelid, so I am kind of creating a new crease for my eyes. And that way my eyes will look really bigger. And taking little by little product, I'm just slowly building it up to avoid any kind of patchiness. If you take a lot of product at a time, then it may become patchy and it will be really hard to blend. So my advice is always take little by little product and just build it up. I'm doing the same thing for my other eye. And I'm not fast forwarding this step because in case you are a beginner, this video will be really helpful for you in case you want to learn how to do cut crease. So I'm not fast forwarding any step. Now I'm taking Hans, which is a beautiful warm brown shade. It's kind of orangish rust color, and with this small blending brush from Morphe, I'm just blending out the edges. You can see the edge of that dark brown shade is looking a little bit harsh, so it needs to be blended, and I'm just blending it out. And just take your time and blend it and it will look perfect. And blend it until or unless you have a nice gradient effect from a darker shade to a lighter shade. And I'm just doing the same here. I'm just slowly blending it out until or unless I'm happy with the blending. And one more thing I forgot to mention, while blending your eyeshadows, always apply minimum pressure. Do not just apply a lot of pressure. It will just create a little bit of peeling underneath, and you do not want that. Now I'm just cutting my crease using a small lip brush from Puna Store, and for that first I'm just marking the area where I want to place my cut crease. And I'm placing the concealer a little bit higher, you can see, because I have hooded eyes, so I'm kind of creating a new crease for me. Now I'm just applying the concealer right where the brown is peeping through. I do not like to apply the concealer all over my eyelid again because this way it just looks a bit heavy and crusty. And just removing the concealer with a micellar water and reapplying it, it's just a lot of hassle, so I do not like to do that. Now I am taking this matte black shade with this e.l.f. blending brush. I am applying it on the outer V area. And again, you can see I am taking little by little product and I'm just blending it out. Because with the darker shades, if you take a lot of product at a time, it will be really, really difficult to blend, and you do not want that. And I am applying it mainly on my outer V area. I'm not dragging the color all the way towards my inner corners. You can totally see. And if you apply a darker shade on your outer V area, it just gives your outer V area very nice smoky effect, and your eyes just in general look really, really bigger. And I'm doing the same thing on my other eye as well. And the outer view area was looking a bit harsh, so I'm just blending out the black eyeshadow with my transition shade again. And for that I have used the shade Hans, and I'm just slowly blending it out. You can see in that eye, the black is looking a little bit harsh, and we do not want that harshness on the edge. We want a very nice smooth gradient effect, right? Now I'm taking Pool Party, which is a beautiful shimmery sea green color, and with this flat shader brush from Morphe, I'm applying it all over on my eyelid. And you can see I am kind of tapping the color, because if you just swipe your brush, then the shimmer will not stick to your eyelid. So whenever you are using any shimmery shade, try to just pat it, or you can use your fingertip to pat the product. And in case your shimmer is not sticking onto your eyelid, you can always use a glitter primer underneath, or you can just wet your brush with a makeup setting spray and just tap the shimmer on your eyelid, and it should look perfect. Now I am taking Royalty, which is a shimmery purple color. I am applying it in between the black shade and the shimmery sea green shade, and again I'm just patting the color. You can see I'm not swiping it at all, so I'm just kind of patting the color first, and then I'll be blending it out with the black shade as well as with the sea green shade. And you can see I'm blending it out at the same time, because if you just apply the color and leave it, then it creates a straight mark and it doesn't look good. So you need to blend it out with the other shades as well. Now I'm taking Cheap again with a very small definer brush. I'm applying it on the border of that cut crease to make it look crisp, to make it look prominent. Whenever I'm not using any glitter eyeliner on my cut crease, I always make sure to follow this step. I always take a darker shade and I just apply it on the border of my cut crease. That way my cut crease just looks so much prominent. You can see the difference it just made. Now I'm just drawing a wing using my Wet n Wild Mega Liner in the shade black, and for that I'm using an eyeliner brush from Morphe. Now whenever you apply your eyeliner, try to use a brush, because if you use a felt tip eyeliner on top of a glitter or a shimmery shade, it may look streaky. But if you use an eyeliner brush, it doesn't look streaky and you will get that perfect eyeliner. For my waterline, I'm using a black eyeliner pencil or black kajal pencil, and I'm applying it on my waterline as well as my upper lash line. This way it will just look cohesive. Now I'm taking the black shade on an angled brush from Pune store. I'm just smudging out my entire lower lash line, and I am making my lower lash line a bit smokier than usual. This way if you have a lot of fine lines underneath, it will be just concealed and your eyes will look brighter and bigger. I'm applying the same sea green shade on the inner part of my eyelid. Basically I'm following the same order that I followed for my eyelids, and I'm applying the purple shade right here on the outer part of my lower lash line. Now I'm taking Enlighten, which is the first shade of the palette. I'm just highlighting my brow bones, and for that I'm using a flat shader brush again from Pune store. And also my inner corners. This is such a stunning shade and I love to use it to highlight my brow bones as well as my inner corners. Now I'm just elongating the inner corner, the eyeliner on my inner corner. It just gives that sultry effect to the look. And now I'm just curling my natural lashes with this Figa eyelash curler, and I'm applying a coat of mascara. This is my Essence Lash Princess mascara, and I'm just coating my top and bottom lashes. I will be using falsies off camera. Of course, this look needs falsies. And here is the final look. I have used Kiss Lashes in the Style Gala off camera, and I truly loved how the entire look turned out, because I love colorful looks and this is like my kind of looks. And I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I hope this video was helpful for you. If you did, then please give me a thumbs up and please share this video with your friends and family. It will mean a lot to me. And if you are not following me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, then please do follow me there. All the links will be given in the description bar down as well, so please do check that out. So yes, see you soon in my next one. Till then, bye and take care.